Bob Willis there, England's depressed cricket captain. It's far from depression on the football field. I've just had word that, in fact, England won that match against Luxembourg, not 8-0, as I said earlier. Phil Neal of Liverpool scored in the 90th minute, and it was 9-0.
And the headlines again. In tonight's emergency debate on nuclear missiles, Dennis Healey accused the government of prompting jingoistic hysteria. But the Foreign Secretary spoke against what he called naive optimism over arms control. And the health dispute is finally over after 8 months. And finally, a Cardiff bus driver, Trevor George, went to the registry office today to register a name for his baby daughter. He's a football fan, and the name on the certificate read Jennifer Pele, Ball, Jairzinho, Rivellino, Carlos Alberto, Cesar Breitner, Greaves, Best, Moore, Keegan Banks, Gray, Francis, Brooking, Curtis, Toshak, Law, Charlton, Cruyff, George. But Mrs. George was furious. She stormed off to the registrar and knocked out all those footballers' names. Now she's gone home to mother. From me, John Desmond Humphreys, good night.
Good evening to you. Well, you won't need me to tell you that today's main feature has been the strong wind, and that's going to continue. There is something else going on, though, and this all hinges around this cold front. That'll be continuing to move down across the country during the course of tonight and at first tomorrow, bringing us all into these quite stiff, cold, northwesterly winds, and they'll be bringing through a fair number of wintry showers. Now, if we look at the satellite picture, you can see that cold front as it was 2 or 3 hours ago. There isn't actually very much to show, but it is lying through central parts of the country, but with the strong winds, the cloud on it has just about been shredded to pieces. But more important, you see already coming in towards northern areas a fair number of pretty hefty showers. So as far as the details concerned, well, with that cold front around in southern parts, I think the night there will stay fairly windy and cloudy and probably reasonably mild too, with some rain from time to time. But elsewhere, that central and northern areas, already the weather's turning progressively colder, and as time goes on, you'll have some showers, all right, and they will become increasingly wintry during the course of the night. And I think especially in these northern areas, there'll be a fair bit of snow over the hills there, and that snow drifting in those continuing very strong winds. Tomorrow, the southernmost parts of the country, possibly starting off still on the mild side with some cloud and outbreaks of rain, but I think that'll move away during the first part of the day. The weather then brightening up and turning colder, and then we're really all in the same boat. It'll be a mixture of sunshine and showers and quite a cold and windy day. The further north you go, so the heavier and more frequent the showers will become, and in these northern areas, many of them will be of sleet and snow, and over the hills especially, that snow drifting.
Entertainment for Christmas on BBC One. Peter Ustinov heads the star-studded cast of Agatha Christie's Death on the Nile.
Clara, the way I see it, everybody could have done it. And everybody had a reason for doing it.
Of course. We know almost all there is to know. Except that what we know seems incredible.
It's incredible.
In Airport 77, the hijacking of a luxury jet leads to frightening consequences.
Nobody is going to drown. The plane is pressurized.
Have you radioed for help?
Radios don't work underwater, but our course has been tracked on radar, and they know exactly where we went down.
In King Kong, dreams of riches are shattered by the world's mightiest beast. In Convoy, the tough humor of the men who ride America's highways.
Convoy, ain't she a beautiful sight? Come on and join our convoy, ain't nothing but a getting our way. We can't go this stuck in convoy across the USA.
Action and adventure for Christmas on BBC One.
All right, now it's action and adventure all the way in our classic spaghetti western. Clint Eastwood, Lee Van Cleef, and Eli Wallach as the good, the bad, and the ugly.